Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, bismillah, alhamdulillah. This is your brother Bilal, inshallah, with a series titled The Footprints of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam, where we look at some of the lasting impressions that Prophet Ibrahim left behind for us so that we may follow in his footsteps. This last moment that I would like to share with you all is a meeting in Jannah. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is on the night journey and he's going up in these levels of Jannah. And he reaches the highest level of Jannah, the seventh level, where he finds Prophet Ibrahim leaning on the Kaaba of the angels, Bayt al-Ma'mur. And how befitting is the one that built the Kaaba in the dunya is leaning on the Kaaba of in Jannah, subhanAllah. And I want you to imagine this. This is in the seventh level of Jannah. Who is this conversation between? The Prophet Ibrahim and the Prophet Muhammad. And Prophet Ibrahim tells Prophet Muhammad, O Muhammad, give your ummah my salams. So all the way from the seventh heaven, 1400 years ago, Prophet Ibrahim told the Prophet Muhammad to tell you, Assalamu alaikum. So subhanAllah, Ibrahim is giving advice to Prophet Muhammad. And he says that Jannah is beautiful, the water is luxurious, and the soil is productive, but the land is plain. How can something be productive but have nothing to show for it? So Ibrahim says, in order to plant the seed so that soil can show the productivity, is to plant the seeds by uttering Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wa Allahu Akbar. So what we find is that Ibrahim is giving us advice. In order for us to grow our trees, in order for us to grow our forest in Jannah, we have to keep our tongue moist with the remembrance of Allah, as he sallallahu alayhi wasallam has said. So say, Subhanallah, alhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wa Allahu Akbar. Repeat this with your children. Tell your children every single morning and every single night. Do you want to build a tree in Jannah before we start our day? Do you want to build a tree in Jannah before we sleep? Let's just say, Subhanallah, alhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wa Allahu Akbar. My brothers and sisters, the last jewel and gem that I would like to extract and leave for you all as I conclude this series is from the legacy of Ibrahim. You're walking in these footsteps of not just Ibrahim, but all of his progenies, Ismail, Ishaq, Yaqub, Yusuf, Musa, Isa, and Muhammad. And what we find is this, is that when you sacrifice for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like Ibrahim did, something very powerful happens, not just to you, but to your offsprings, to your legacy in this life and in the next. My brothers and sisters, sacrifice for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Follow in the footsteps of the Prophet Ibrahim. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us, to accept from this series, and to accept our deeds. I hope you all benefited. Jazakallahu khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.